Hello students, I warmly welcome to English online class. Today we are going to see the supplementary reader, The Aged Mother, part 2. Already we had seen part 1. Finally, young poor farmer lifted his mother again. He was moving. So we'll continue today. Hidden his mother in little huts. He was hiding his mother in a little hut near the valley because he wanted to save his mother, and also he had given some food. He made his mother comfortable, supplying her everything. And next moment, despotic leader issued other order. Already he had issued an order, aged people must be killed. Many aged people were killed by the despotic leader. So now again he issued a different difficult order. What is an order means? The people should present a rope of ashes. So using ashes, they wanted to present a rope. They wanted to make a rope. This is an order which was issued by despotic leader in shining country. A rope of ashes. Using ashes, they wanted to make a rope. And the next moment, the people in shining country trembled with fear because most of the people were youngsters. Only young people were living, because the aged persons who were killed by the despotic leader, only the young people who were living in that shining country. No one knows how to make a rope of ashes. So next moment, this news somehow reached to the young poor farmer. So immediately the poor farmer told this news to his mother. So after hearing this, mother asked his son, "Son, wait for a moment. I will think. Definitely I will tell you an idea." So mother said to her son, "So wait for some moment. Sure, I will tell you an idea." So after some moments, mother was thinking and she told a nice idea to her son. What is that idea means? Mother, she was making a rope by burning a twisted straw on a windless night. So wanted to take a twisted straw and it was burning. We kept it in a windless night. Can you understand? We have to take a burning twisted straw and we kept it in a windless night. So if you do like that, means definitely we will get a rope of ashes. A rope by burning a twisted straw, and after burning this, we keep it in a windless night. So if you check in the next day, means definitely we will get the rope using the ashes. So this is an idea mother told her son. So after that, the young poor farmer son, he followed his mother's advice, idea, and he made a rope of ashes. Finally, he made a rope of ashes. Okay, so all the ideas and mother instructed, she explained all that, and following mother's words, he made a nice rope of ashes. So what happened next? He presented a rope of ashes to the despotic leader. The young poor farmer went to meet the despotic leader and he presented a rope of ashes. And the despotic leader asked, so how could you make this? Tell me. So how could you make this? And immediately the young poor farmer bent down and he apologized. So why did he apologize? Means, so I did not kill my mother. Okay? And my mother only gave an idea. So followed her words. So I made a rope of ashes. So after hearing this, the despotic leader praised the young poor farmer, as well as he asked the young poor farmer to bring his mother here. So immediately the young poor farmer went to brought his mother. And next moment, the leader appreciated young poor farmer as well as his mother. Because of mother's intelligence and brilliance, he made a rope of ashes. So the despotic leader appreciated both of them, especially the mother. Okay, so finally, cruel law abolished. Cruel law was abolished. He was abolished the cruel law, whatever he did in the past, as well as this one. So all the cruel law were abolished by the despotic leader. And he has changed the character also. He knew his mistake. Whatever he had committed in the past, he rectified, he knew very well. After hearing the rope of ashes which was made by the mother, he changed his character totally. So finally, he realized his mistake. Despotic leader realized his mistake. The cruel law was abolished. So, in this story, in the beginning of the story, he had issued an order, the old people must be killed. So, followed his words, many aged people were killed. So, finally, the mother, she was an aged person. She only told the idea. So, what is the theme? What is the moral of the story? The aged mother, old people, old persons, aged people are highly intelligent and witty. Aged people, old people are highly intelligent. So old is gold. We have to respect the old people. We have to respect the old people. We have to follow the advice of the old people. In our place, in our home, our grandparents, also the many persons, many aged people who are living around our house, in village, so wherever. So whether they are giving any ideas, any advice, means we must follow that. We won't neglect their words. We must follow their advice, means definitely we will be also like them. We are also like an intelligent person, because they had learned a lot in their life. They had learned a lot in their life. They are sharing with us. We want to hear those words. It is very useful to our life. We won't neglect. We thought that we are intelligent person. Not like that. So apart from the education, So aged persons, they are teaching a lot to us. So we want to learn from the aged persons, the story or advice. So whatever it may be, we want to learn. We want to hear those persons' words. Definitely it will be very useful to our future. So in this story, so the old people are intelligent, wise, brilliant, highly witty. So this is the theme and moral of the story. Okay, can you understand the story, the aged mother? So read the story, read the textual lines. Definitely you can understand. So hereafter, you have to respect the old person. Okay, definitely your life also become very happy. Okay, read the story in your book. We'll see you in next class, students. Thank you all.